Hey everybody, Jason Yee here, and welcome to this How to Skate Like McDavid 6 week tutorial. And today you're going to skate 10 to 15% faster. And how are we going to do that? We're going to look at literally one simple trick to McDavid's mechanics that you're going to find to be so non-intuitive and so easy, and you'll actually be shocked as to why you hadn't just done this earlier. It'll kind of actually throw you off a bit. So what we're looking at is one thing, and it's the mechanics of his arm swing. Now, where we're at right now is we are at week 3 of 6. And so this presentation will make sense to you, but you're not going to get the full benefit of it unless you actually go and watch the first 2 weeks. So I'm going to link those in the top right corner so you can go and watch those. And like I said, today we're going to adjust some of your mechanics in a non-intuitive way. And I'm going to walk you through how adjusting your arm swing mechanics will boost your speed without additional effort. And I'm going to also show you the common stumbling blocks that most players experience when trying to do this that ends up keeping them slow. So who I am is I'm a former pro kinesiologist, founder of Trade 2.0. My name is Jason Yee. And in studying mechanics, I'm going to show you exactly how to get faster without extra effort. So here's how we're going to do it. If you've watched the first 2 weeks, you're right in the middle of a 6 week program. If you're not, I suggest that you go back and watch the first 2 weeks and get started there. I'm releasing the first 3 weeks of this free on YouTube, and this is going to make a massive improvement in your skating effortlessness and speed. And then the last 3 weeks of this are released inside of the downhill skating system, which has a 30-day money back guarantee. So you actually have the opportunity to get the full 6 weeks fully for free. And then, you know, if you follow the coaching, you get some great results, you might want to complete the training and stick around and watch be part of the whole downhill skating system. And obviously, if you're, you know, just an armchair player or like armchair coach and you do nothing with this information, nothing will change. And you obviously won't see results. And, that's not why I'm doing this presentation. It's actually for players to get results. So, you know, where we're at is week one. We talked about fixing your push angle. That was the first video. And week two, which was last week's video, we talked about your inner spring. And then this is all about learning the inner spring arm swing. And that's today. So last week, I talked about the mechanics of the inner spring, which is that if you really want to locomote, meaning if you want to actually go forward, your body has to oppose each other. And there's a great view of that right here, where you're going to see like a overhead version of these guys skating. And what you see is that even though they're going in a straight line this way, what ends up happening is they really end up driving laterally. And so that was like the last 2 weeks. It really triggers your inner spring. So it's something we call the inner spring, which is your core musculature that is actually set up to promote energy transfer from your upper and lower body. And when you use your inner spring, your forward stride blends into your other movements, making everything easier. Now let's take a look at McDavid's actual arm swing here. And you know, if we actually zoom back here and take a look right off the bat, what you're gonna see really clearly is just how much he swings his arms side to side. But I'm gonna focus you in on one specific thing, which is that he throws his arm back so hard, and you can see it right here, that it actually creates a stretch across his pectoral muscle. So what you're actually seeing here, and I'll back it up to the exact frame where it is he actually swings his arm, and you can kind of see how the pendulum effect creates a stretch across his pec right here. And then the way that you're going to be able to tell that is you can actually see how it pulls the shoulder back. Are you seeing how right there, because of his arm swing, it pulls the shoulder back? And then you can kind of see the shoulder reload back to you here. And so you're going to see several examples of how basically what he's doing is using his hand and swinging it really hard back in order to get a stretch through his pectoral muscle right here. And so you can really see that it causes a stretch right there. And the reason we call this the inner spring arm swing is because, you know, if you really look at how much McDavid's upper body is moving, it's like all over the place. Like, look how much his shoulders go from being over here to fully shifting over this way. And yeah, of course the camera angle's changing, but like, look how, you know, noisy his upper body is. It's all over the place. And, you know, this is one of my favorite views of it, because you can just see how his, if we go right here, you can see how his head is here, his shoulders are here. Like, both shoulders are right here. Watch as he strides how far they move across. And you can see how that hand has pulled back, that pec is stretched right there. And then watch the next stride again, how far his shoulders move across. All right, we'll pause it right here where his shoulders are, and then we'll see how far he ends up moving across this way. And you can again see that stretch across there. And all of this arm swing is triggering this inner spring here, like this. So what is the secret? The secret is this free hand right here. And you can, of course, do it on the stick hand as well, and you want to. But what you can see right in this specific position is a stretch across the pec. And the stretch across the pec is going to pull the shoulders, and pulling the shoulders is going to create that stretch across your inner spring right there. So to learn the McDavid arm swing, you want to swing hard and straight enough. You want your hand to be straight enough to feel a stretch in your pectoral muscle. This should actually throw you off balance if you're used to power skating. So if you're used to your standard power skating stride, when you swing your arm like this, it should throw you off balance. It should feel quite weird and awkward. Now what you want to do is you want to let your arm swing guide your lower body push angle and rhythm, meaning that now that you are using McDavid's arm swing, you're going to actually use that off balanceness to guide the direction of your stride. And this sounds so odd that I would say you should adapt yourself to an off-balance stride. But you'll see that as you forget what you've always been told and tune into the feel of the movement, and you actually really test out this McDavid arm swing, what you're going to find is that you're going to end up feeling way more effortless, way more relaxed. And I'm going to go ahead and you know, put it out there, 10 to 15% faster. And, you know, I've said this before, I don't want you to take my word for it. I don't want you to, you know, just take it at face value. I want you to go test this out and pay attention to what you notice. And what do you have to lose? You know, go out to a practice and give that arm a really good swing. Feel it across the pec. Let it throw you off balance. Adjust your stride and then see what happens. And I think you're really going to be surprised. So what's next here is you're going to want to get to work. You want to test out this drill progression with an open mind, and also stay and get subscribed to the Train 2.0 channel so you can get more mechanics breakdowns like this in the future. And, you know, some of you guys might want to get started on the downhill skating system right now. And so I've prepared a free training for you so you guys can get yourself signed up for that. Otherwise, we'll see you in next week, week 4, where we're going to talk about the getting leverage with your skate angle, how to really get amazing leverage with your skate angle and reduce the amount of effort that's needed to stride just by adjusting the way that you skate. So we'll see you guys then. Thanks for watching.